Hello everyone, this ongoing investigation seeks answers about the perception of the citizens of San Luis, Argentina, about their participation in public affairs. It seeks to know how citizens perceive their participation in public policies promoted by the state with the management of Governor Alberto Rodríguez Saá, how they understand and qualify the communication and information that the government deploys towards citizens, and what they are the alternatives or instances that citizens can consider as probably better. San Luis is a small province located in the center of the country, with a population close to 5,000 inhabitants. Since December 1983, the Rodríguez brothers have governed the small province of San Luis in Argentina, and for more than 35 years they built an almost seamless powers and the Peronist Party into an electoral machine that won the election. Adolfo and Alberto Rodríguez Saá took turns in the exercise of government, previously obtained the adherence of the citizens and their management. They co-opted the judiciary and legislative bodies, disorganized the opposition, and always controlled the Peronist Party. Cervasoni rightly points that although subnational governments are less autonomous than national ones, they are not necessarily less important. In Argentina and many countries in the region, a large and growing proportion of public spending and the fall of state action is executed by province and municipalities. Almost two-thirds of Argentina's civil servants belong to the province, a figure that grows to around 80% if municipal employees are considered. Furthermore, Gerbasoni explained that indefinite re-election can be taken as an indicator of little electoral competition. Governors who accumulate a lot of power can achieve indefinite re-election, which make a democracy work. The power accumulated by the government is incompatible with the competition, rotation and division of powers that indicate that this province have a greater concentration of power in the executive to the detriment of the other powers. In this province that Gerbasoni calls hybrid, the governments go and control everything. Gerbasoni indicates that there are rich states, but not because they tax rich companies, but because of the federal co-participation law, they have a very high amount of money per capita. They are a very rich state because of the income from fiscal federalism. This means that some governments have a lot of money for social plans and build societies that depend on public employment of those plans, on their own media or control the province media, thought the guideline. Governments tend to understand this quickly and began to accumulate power. They began to win election with significant majorities, to have a majority in the legislature, in the congressman, and they begin to change the electoral rules. And what is the citizen participation and mobilization in San Luis province? citizen mobilization, awareness of the possibilities for participation in San Luis in public decisions can be understood as the first thought, the first action in search of access, interaction, and citizen participation. In San Luis, citizen mobilization have been sporadic and silenced by the official media. Despite the scenario is presenting is a disjointed civil society that expresses of civic culture of disinterest in public issues. On the one hand, and the other, absent of social dialogue, which the government does not open clearly, and which have any possibilities for participatory process. In this context, it appears from the hands of powers, the epic and governmental methodology to fill the missing space, even in disarticulation and in the lack of homely in action in relation to insubordination and civil disobedience. Scott has argued that small individual acts can become, under certain circumstances, authentic social phenomena capable of trigger for reaching political change. This research is about the level of participate in San Luis province of the citizen. Thank you very much.